observation of atheism, one of the things that has come to my attention over the last couple of years is that atheism is a psychological crutch. This can be easily demonstrated on a number of fronts, but one of the reasons why atheism is a psychological crutch is on the issue of loss and certainty. When somebody loses something in their life, they need something to hold on to. So, for example, if you lose a loved one in your family, it causes a great chasm in your life, but you need something or someone to help you through that sense of loss. And one of the ways to deal with loss is to hold on to something that gives you certainty. Now, there has been a sense of loss on a personal and on a ideological level with many atheists. I'll just give an example of the personal loss. For example, Hitchens lost his mother, and he lost his mother with down to a renegade clergyman who left the clergy but became some kind of weird psychedelic, and he went off with Hitchens' mum, and then they committed suicide. Now Hitchens has lost something personal there, and in order to deal with that, he needed to hold on to something. And what he held on to was atheism, that helped him to really channel his anger at the Judeo-Christian faith, that in a way he would blame for that loss. So it helped him to deal with that situation. So it's atheism was his psychological crutch. Another example is Richard Dawkins, and we've looked at the personal level with Hitchens. Now let's just look at the wider scientific and philosophical level of the psychological crutch in action. In the history of scientific thought recently, science has come under the last 20 years especially, has come under a massive assault from the philosophy of science, with people like Karl Popper and Michael Polanyi and others. Also with the renewal, the sort of revival of postmodern thinking, which has seeped into scientific thinking. People of the old modernist school of science, the idea of some kind of finding certain knowledge within science that is objective, has been severely challenged. And people of that old school, such as Richard Dawkins, would feel vulnerable, and their position in society and in the academic world would feel vulnerable, because there are no certainties anymore. So in order to maintain some kind of certainty within the scientific disciplines, one creates an enemy, i.e. the creatards, i.e. the creationists. And as you create an enemy, you create a polarization between the creatards and those who are truly scientific with a true scientific objective knowledge, thereby giving you a sense of identity and certainty as a scientist. And that is what Dawkins has done. In the flux of scientific thinking, where relativism has come in because of the postmodern reflection and challenged objective science, People like Dawkins have felt insecure with that and needed security, so they've created an enemy in order to create a polarization, in order to give them a sense of identity and certainty. Again, a psychological crutch. You look at the key thinkers in atheism over the last 100 years, and every one of them will have a deep psychological flaw and a need for atheism to help them with that deep psychological flaw. Another one is Nietzsche. Nietzsche had problems with his father. His father was a Christian, and Nietzsche reacted against that. And in a way, his atheism was, in a way, seeking a kind of father-like figure in his life. Someone who he could relate to. And that relationship, someone who he could relate to, was his own inflated ego, which became, in a way, a kind of surrogate father. I'm getting good at this, aren't I? So there we are. Atheism is a psychological crutch. Take care, and God bless you.